scored by 10-11. EA Sports first star.
Hello, everyone. Welcome back for game two of our NHL 95 season. We're heading out east to Long Island to play the Islanders. Let's get this going.
Tonight, from the Arrowhead Pond in Anaheim, EA Sports presents the game between the New York Islanders and the Mighty Ducks of Anaheim. Here are tonight's lineups.
The Islanders had a good season in 1993-94, going 36-36-12 for 84 points, getting eliminated in the first round. The Islanders are led by the powerful offensive attack of Pierre Turchon, Steve Thomas, Derek King, and Benoit Hogg, all 30-plus goal scorers. So they got a lot of offensive firepower going for them. As you can see there, hockey fans will recognize the former Thrasher, the big ball of hate, the journeyman Ray Ferraro from his coverage on NBC or the Debury NHL games. Yui Krupp on the blue line, along with Darius Kasparaitis and Vladimir Malikov, good heavy hitters. And backstopped by the veteran journeyman Ron Hextall in one of his later seasons. Also of note, 1993-94 was the last full-time coaching season for veteran Islanders coach Al Arbour, who led them to all those Stanley Cups back in the 70s. Oh, a quick one-timer, and Hextall will stop that one and hold on for a whistle. Aside from a brief one-game stint of relief in 2007-2008, this would be Al Arbour's last season. Very important name in Islanders history. There's Pierre Turgeon, 24 at the time. Go on to a big career if I wouldn't kill him. Oh, that makes me feel bad.
Anaheim penalty to number 34, 2 minutes for roughing at 51 seconds.
Yeah, unfortunately, Pierre Turgeon's career was cut short by concussions and injuries like that one. So let's pretend we're not contributing to that. Jimmy Sasquatch over the blue line. Rip that one right in front. This puck picked up by the Islanders. Let's see if I can remember these guys' names. Travis Green gives it to Brad Delgarno with a quick shot. And they'll pick up a line change here. Coming back the other way. Ray Ferraro on the right-hand side with a shot that came back in front. And then he's taken down by a pseudonym. Anaheim will make a line change. Genghis Khan will dump that one in. Here comes Ferraro again with another long shot. Oh, the puck loose in front. Oh, it gives that one away like he shouldn't have. Picked up by Mifflin. Mifflin gives it to number 35, Michael Hollimer, with a quick shot. And that power play will be over for New York. And a new one will be starting.
Number 43, 2 minutes.
Expo Jackson.
At 3:05.
Even barely 3 minutes in, I've already got two penalties. The start of things to come. It's off to the right of L10. Won by the Islanders. Taken down by Nathan Ormond. Nathan Ormond goes on a breakaway. Oh, the backhander. He scores over the puck side on Hextall.
Curious
fourth goal of the
season.
A shorty, no less. Unassisted. Nicely done. Got the wheels to make things happen. Face off won by the Islanders. Hoag loses the puck. Let's give it to pseudonym. Quick shot. Oh, Hextall loses that one. Whoa, he took him down with a shot right to the head. You're to blame. And L10's going to cover that one up because there's too many unfriendly blue jerseys. Don't forget back then, they wore the light color jerseys at home, the whites, the home whites, and the road aways were the dark jerseys. They switched that since everybody's got a third jersey now. There's Orman. He'll spin around and he'll shoot that one in. Chance gives it to Ray Ferraro, who will dump it for another line change. And the puck will sit right in front of the net because L-10-11 can't get off his ass and get it. Picked up for the Islanders by Lachance. Lachance gives it to Brad Delgarno, who will fire it wide of the net. That'll end that penalty. Anaheim will get a well-deserved line change. Derek King with the shot. L-10 with a quick save. Fox over the blue line with the shot. It's blocked right in front of the net. Another shot and a great glove save by Ron Hextall. And he'll hold on to that one. Four stoppage of play. Get some fresh legs on the ice for Anaheim. And the Islanders win the faceoff. Ormond steals it. Ormond loses the puck. Picked up by the end boards. By number 27, Derek King. Over the line. He's taken down with a poke check, and the Islanders will be whistled for offsides. And a fresh faceoff now. Again won by the Islanders, because I suck at faceoffs. Steve Thomas will go offsides. And we'll get another faceoff, which I'll probably lose. And I lose a face-off, just as predicted. Long shot wide of the net by Keith Acton. Taken down and the end boards by Spencer Robinson, who gives it to Ibagbar with a quick shot. And it's knocked aside by the blocker of Ron Hextall. Taken down in the end boards. Bauer with a long cross-ice pass. Oh, he can't find Bo Jackson. He's taken down. Oh, lots of hitting here. Spencer Robinson with a quick shot. Oh, he can't get the... Iceback Cometh had a wide open net and he couldn't convert on that one. Delgado with a shot. Stopped by L10. Long pass to Mark Maurer. And Hextall will stop that one. Ducks will make a line change here. Robinson will chip it down the end boards. Now it's the Islanders making a line change. He whistles that one over the net. Ormond picks it up. Ormond to Genghis Khan with the backhander. Hextall makes the quick stop on that. Kasparaitis is taken down. Genghis Khan with a one-timer to Nathan Ormond. And he can't find the back of the net. Hextall will hold on to that one with half a minute, half the period to play in the first. Face-off won by, I don't know. Sasquatch with the backhander. Can't find the back of the net. Sasquatch will take down Steve Thomas and pick up the loose puck. Sasquatch down the left-hand side boards, looking for that cross pass, but he can't find it. So he's going to shoot it in right there. Hextall with a quick save. Picked up in front by Yui Krupp, who turns it over to Shockmaster, who tries the backhander but can't find it in. Ferraro taken down at the blue line. Loose puck picked up by the Ducks. Ducks make a line change and Shockmaster will dump it. Uh-oh. The puck rolls all the way down the end boards and the Islanders will be whistled for icing. See, back then you could still make a line change on an icing call. They made that rule a couple years ago. Team that ices the puck can't make a line change. Ormond with the steal, tries to do the one-timer. Oh, and Hextall's right there. Let's stop that one right in front of the net. Stop one by the Islanders. Gives it to Patrick Flatley. Over the blue line. He's taken down with a quick poke check. Here comes Nova Fox with the shot. Hextall holds on to that one. Passes it to Dennis Vasque, number 37. Maurer moving the puck around. Picked up, loose puck picked up by Hibagbar. Maurer to Jackson. Jackson with a quick shot. Stick save by Ron Hextall. Who gives it to Dennis Vasque? To Patrick Flatley. to make the shot. Oh, come on, get it out. Thank you. Maurer is taken down, but anyway. Here comes Bo Jackson with the backhander. Nothing happening there. Benoit Hogue loses the puck. And, of course, nobody can pick it up. Long shot, stopped by L10. Who gives it to Pseudonym? Who gives it to McKay with the quick goal? The sneaky deep move to put it past him. For his first goal of the season.
Anaheim goal scored by number 20, assisted by number 13 and number 10.
I'll get the helper on that one. Good for me. That puts the Ducks up 2-0 here. Closing quarter of the first period. So one by the Islanders, because I'm not even trying anymore. Oh, he's taken down. Shockmaster picks up the loose puck. Shockmaster hassled on the left-hand side. He's not going to be able to get a shot off. And he loses the puck. Picked up by Sasquatch. And a delayed call against the Islanders.
Islanders penalty to number 24. 2 minutes for hooking at 15-12.
Keith Acton going to the bench. Going to the sin bin. He's gonna get no Acton there. The Mighty Ducks on a power play now. Let's see what they can get anything done here. Oh, win the faceoff. A quick shot from Genghis Khan is stopped. Ducks will be offside. Ormond will regroup. Ormond behind the back of the net. Passes around. Can't find a recipient. McKay picks it up. Oh, Genghis Khan right there in front. The quick one-timer is stopped by Ron Hextall. Ooh, hold on to it for a face-off. Face-off won by Anaheim. Oh, the pass is intercepted. That cross-ice pass trying to set up that one-timer. Puck is knocked around loose in the neutral zone. Picked up by Action Bo Jackson. Long pass. Oh, he just went too far past. Couldn't find the side of the net. Travis Green loses the puck to Action Jackson. Cross-ice pass. Oh, he's still... Maurer's got too much speed on that one. That's going to end that power play. Robinson will dump it in for a line change, and he'll do it again. Couldn't dump it well the first time. Ron Hextall does some goofy stuff. Genghis Khan, right in front of the net. His shot is blocked. Picked up by Vladimir Malikov. Longtime defenseman. Ormond down the left-hand side. Gets off that one-timer, but it's whistled wide of the net. Genghis Khan. Pass is picked up instead by Pseudonym. Gets off the quick shot, but can't find the back of the net. Marty McKinnis loses the puck. Loose puck right at center ice.
1 minute left in the period.
Stole from Travis Green. Ormond behind the back of the net. He tries to ring it around the end boards for a pass to a recipient who is not there. Half a minute left. Here comes Mifflin over the blue line with a 1-on-3. I like those odds. Oh, a big check on transpires is taken down. That's going to be the end of the first period.
Here is the scoring summary for the first period.
Anaheim up 2-0. Nathan Ormond on pace to score, I don't know, 300 goals.
We take you now to the St. Louis Arena for an EA Sports highlight of the game between the New Jersey Devils and the St. Louis Blues. And elsewhere in the NHL tonight.
Let's look at our game statistics as they have gone so far. 26 shots as usual, putting up all the shots. More penalties for everyone. Look at that attack zone, half the period almost. Very well done. And doubling them up on body checks. And 4-11 in faceoffs. Oh, go figure.
And now, back to the game.
Teams will switch sides for the second period. With Anaheim on a 2-0 lead. Face off won by Anaheim. Hooray. McKay, who tries to get that one-timer off. There's nobody there. Face off by nobody. But the Ducks will pick it up. Ormond skates around a bit. Shot taken away. Derek King will give it to Ray Ferraro with another quick shot. L10 will stop that one. Turns it over. Uh-oh.
Anaheim penalty to number 65. 2 minutes for elbowing.
I think Genghis Khan would break the rules. That's going to be another power play for the Islanders, who have nothing to show for it so far. They're going to need to score if they want to get back into this game. So, the Islanders. Gives it to Benoit Hogue with a long shot. Uh-oh. Islanders on a line change. Oh, he bought Bauer on a breakaway. He scores. Fancy ass move.
Anaheim goal scored by number 17, assisted by number 10.
Can't let him do that. He'll burn you every time. Actually, the second helper for L10. Good for me. I'm a cool guy that way. Won by the Islanders, but Ferraro is taken down by Action Jackson. Oh, he scores! What a nice move there.
Anaheim goal scored by number 43.
Bo's trying to even up Nathan Ormond, and that's gonna bring the hook for Rod Hextall after only 22 minutes. That's gonna bring in the backup, Jamie McLennan. Longtime backup goaltender. So up one by the Islanders. Travis Green gives it to Brad Delgarno. Delgarno is hassled by Buck Bauer. A quick one-timer, can't find an opening. Maurer passes it to no one. Oh, Mifflin with the quick shot from the slot. Can't find a way through. Clinton holds onto it for the face-off. Stuff won by the Ducks. Quick one-timer by Michael Hallmar. And that one will be ringed around the end boards of the glass. Lots of happy campers in the pond tonight. Mifflin loses that puck stolen by Ferraro. Ferraro's shot will be knocked away in front. Sasquatch gives it to Maurer. Maurer right in front. Pulled some fancy deke moves, but couldn't get it in. It's off one by the Ducks. That pass is intercepted. Steve Thomas picks it up, and he'll lose it. Shockmaster gives it to Iceback Cometh, who's taken down at the blue line. Ferraro gives it to Steve Thomas. Steve Thomas gives it back to Ferraro. That one-timer is not going to find anywhere. And Anaheim will make a line change on the stoppage of play. That number one line back in. By Anaheim. Ormond gets the pass off his skates. And Genghis Khan will go offsides. Because he just can't stop invading places. I don't know. He'll bring the face off outside the attacking zone. One by the Islanders. Ray Ferraro tries to make a pass. It's knocked away. He'll pick it up again. Ferraro picks it up for the third time. Oh, right in front of the goal! And L10 stacking the pads on that good opportunity. Oh, the quick one-timer. And Spencer Robinson stopped. Stonewalled by Jamie McLennan. Here comes Action Jackson. Well, Robinson's got to go offsides because he's not paying attention at all. The backhander! Oh! Beautiful save by McLennan. Stretching out that extension to make that save. That one was marked for the back of the net. So, one by the Ducks. That one-timer is knocked away again. Travis Green with a long shot. Wide of the net. Ormond picks it up. Ormond to Cometh. Come to Genghis Khan. Genghis Khan loses the puck. It's taken away by Tom Gervers, who will take a long shot. Oh, another shot. Well, right in front of the net. And Iceman Cometh will pick it up. And immediately turn it back over to Patrick Flatley. Oh, he takes it down. Islanders all over the attacking zone here. Genghis Khan will dump that one in while the Ducks make a well-deserved line change. Robinson hassles him. He can't knock down Flatley. Flatley on the right-hand side. Flatley dipsy doodles right in front of the net with a shot. And stopped by L10. We'll pass it to Maurer. Maurer loses the puck. Picked up by Patrick Flatley. Who gives it away to Travis Green, whose shot is knocked down. And Bo Jackson coming on a breakaway. Bo Jackson, he scores! Catching him on a line change once again. That open field rush, man.
Anaheim goal scored by number 43, assisted by number 21.
Can't let Bo Jackson do that. How about that? We're halfway to 10. Half of the game to go. Faceoff won by Anaheim, but it's picked up by the Islanders. Keith Acton's taken down by Sasquatch. Sasquatch gives it to Hollimer, who turns it over. It's picked up by Brad Delgarno for the Islanders. Coming back the other way. Delgarno loses it. Gives it to Acton, who's taken down with a poke check by Sasquatch, who fires a shot. He can't get it past him. Another one-timer from the right-hand side, and Hextall will hang on to that. Stop that pressure from that attack. 10 minutes to go in the second frame of this contest. It's off one by the Isles. Puck skitters around behind the boards. And it's stolen by McKay, whose shot is intercepted by Vladimir Malikov, who will make a long shot. The Islanders make a line change. Genghis Khan passes it right in front. Can't find him. Quick hard checks. Oh, Orban boarded right there. Boarded him like he was going into a cheap hotel. And there's going to be a delayed call on the Isles. L10 rushes to the bench for the extra attacker. And he turns it over.
Islanders penalty to number 32. 2 minutes for holding at 11:14.
Steve Thomas to the box. Steve Thomas. Now there's a hockey name if I ever heard one. The only hockeyer name I've heard is Dougie Gilmore. It's up one by the Ducks on the power play. To Shockmaster down the left-hand side. Shockmaster looking for an opening. Can't find it. The puck is knocked away, and Hextall will hold on to it. For a face-off, and both sides will make a line change. With the face-off, to Hextall's left. Or McLennan, I should say. Hextall's on the bench, isn't it? And that's going to end the power play for
Anaheim
the Ducks.
To number 20, 2 minutes for hooking at
Nicholas
11,
McKay,
3.
Stop getting penalties, man. That's what we got for a side of hockey for about a minute and a half. Some more space on the ice here. It's a face-off into the neutral zone. Face-off won by the Ducks. Jackson gives it to Maurer. Back to Jackson, and the pass is knocked away. Jackson right in front with a one-timer. stopped by McLennan. Here comes Ray Ferraro. He's hassled by Jackson. Ferraro skates around with the shot. Oh dear, the puck rolls around right in the crease. And Skeeter Rabbit with a quick move. Devoured it back to Jackson. Jackson tries a backhander. He can't get it past him. Tom Curvers gives it to Derek King. Shot right in front. And that's going to give the Islanders a quick 30-second power play. Get a line change there. As Nova Fox dumps it in. And there was going to be too much pressure in front of the net. So L10 will hold on to that one, and we'll get a fresh face-off and some even strength lines. Nothing doing on the power play there for the Islanders. Face-off won by the Islanders. But it's stolen by Spencer Robinson, or Michael Hollimer. Shockmaster picks up the loose puck. Shockmaster can't quite get an opening, so he whistles the shot past the net. Back in the defensive zone for the Ducks. Sudanen picks it up, gives it to Hollimer with a quick one-timer from Jimmy Sasquatch. It's stopped by McLennan. Picked up behind the end boards by Derek King, and the pass is intercepted by Hollimer. We'll dump it in as the Ducks make a line change on the fly. Oh, McKay with a good shot. Good hard hit. McKay looking for somebody to pass to. Oh, Horvick right in front of that. Rips that one. Over the glove hand side. Jamie McLennan.
Goal scored by number 24. Assisted by number 20 and number 65.
Ethan Orban getting all the goals. Scoring like it's going out of style. One by the Isles. This puck is picked up by Nathan Orman, who just scored. Brings the shot around. Picked up by Benoit Hoog, who gives it to Darius Kasparaitis. Looks like there's going to be a delayed call on the Islanders.
Islanders penalty to number 33, 2 minutes for slashing at 16:48.
Put the Ducks on the power play. See if the Ducks can do anything with this power play. Ready up by two field goals. It's off just outside, inside. The attacking zone. Oh, Bo Jackson just rips one past him. Holy cow. Shot that was!
Anaheim goal scored by number 43.
Wind up and fire it! Face off one by Anaheim and it'll go offsides. Okay, had too much juice on that one. Up one by the Ducks. Fox gives it to Rabbit. Rabbit tries to do something but can't make anything happen. In front of the net, Dennis Vasque loses the puck, picks it up again, and then it's picked up by McKay. McKay gives it to Orban. Orban with a shot! Lennon makes the save.
Islanders penalty to number 28. 2 minutes for cross-checking at 17:48.
Tom Curvers is going to the box for the Isles, and that's going to bring out another power play for the Ducks with 2 minutes left in the second frame. Shot put by the Islanders. Knocked down. Power goes offsides, and Islanders will get a chance to regroup. Oh, here comes Action Jackson. Looking for that pass. Oh, it's intercepted right in front of the net by Kasparaitis. Heads up play. Kasparaitis picks it up for the Islanders, but can't seem to dump it out of the zone. And they do. They're coming on a line change. Here comes Bo Jackson. Bo Jackson, a breakaway! Bo Jackson scores again. Oh, it's like the Tecmo Super Bowl.
Anaheim goal scored by number 43.
How do you let Bo Jackson get open like that? That is not good defense at all. So faceoff won by the Islanders.
1 minute left in the period.
Picked up by Genghis Khan. Genghis Khan, long shot. Stopped by McLennan. A chance.
Islanders penalty.
Picks it up, and that's going to be another late call. On the Islanders. Actually, not delayed at all since he was already holding the puck. Give the Ducks another power play, why don't you? More power. Oh, Genghis Khan goes offside like immediately. Now we have to do it again. It's off one by the Ducks. Babbitt gives it to Mifflin, who gives it to McKay, who loses the puck. Orman picks up the puck. McKay picks that up again. And Lennon will make the save. With 8 seconds left in the period. See if we can do something quick here. Probably not. Yeah, the Islanders win the faceoff and nothing happens.
Here is the scoring summary for the second period.
Ha ha ha! Hibogmaru, you big jerk. No respect for authority. Six goals on only 20 shots. That's efficiency there.
We take you now to the Northlands Coliseum in Edmonton for an EA Sports highlight of the game between the Pittsburgh Penguins and the Edmonton Oilers. Elsewhere in the NHL tonight.
One-timers. Well, that happens. And four penalties for 8 minutes. Look at that attack zone. 18 minutes. That is some good attacking there. Lots of body checks.
And now, back to the game.
Here we go for the final period. The Ducks having an 8-0 lead. Faceoff is won by Islanders. Oh, almost had a breakaway.
Anaheim,
it's another power play
by
goal.
Number 20.
That was a nice little nifty backhander deep move there. How about that? Well done. Faceoff won by the Islanders. Their king is ticked down. Ethan Ormond behind the back of the net. Gives it to McKay with a shot. Glennon will stop that one. Glennon's long pass is intercepted by Ormond. Ormond looking for someone to play with, and Genghis Khan is stopped on the stick-hand side. He gives it to Malakov, who gives it to Ray Ferraro, who's upended by Iceman Cometh, who gives it to Ormond, who can't find the back of the net with that one. McLennan will hold on for a face-off. Someone by the Isles. Chance gives it to Derek King, whose shot is stopped. There's no pass to Howard, and he rips a one-timer, and Action Jackson scores again.
Anaheim goal scored by number 43, assisted by number 17 and number 16.
Can't stop scoring. Yeah, is there anything Bo Jackson can't do? Stop one by the Isles. Shockmaster steals the puck. Shot is knocked down in front. Another shot is blocked. Loose puck picked up by Derek King for the Isles. And he's taken down by Shockmaster. Coming up over the right-hand side with a pass intercepted right in front of the net. Islanders trying to get it out of the zone. Shockmaster gets the puck. Oh, can't find that opening there. With the backhanded one-timer, which is totally a thing you can do in this game. Delayed offsides coming. The Shockmaster will just carry it behind the net, and the Ducks will make a line change. Here come the Islanders coming back the other way. With an Ormond, long cross-ice pass, can't find him, he's held up. Ingus Khan, he picks it up anyway. Islanders trying to get it out of their defensive zone. Patrick Flatley carries it towards the blue line. He's hassled by Genghis Khan, and he loses the puck. Travis Green picks up the loose puck. Green gives it to Kasparaitis, who gives it to Benoit Hogue, and the pass is intercepted and then knocked away. There comes McKay, and the Ducks will make a line change. McKay will dump it in. Clennon picks up the loose puck. Uh-oh, Bo Jackson coming up again. Oh, he's not going to get that one there. The backhander is stopped. Tom Kervis gives the puck to Marty McKinnis, who's hassled by Spencer Robinson. McKinnis' shot is wide of the net. Long pass from L10 to Spencer Robinson. The cross-ice pass, trying to do that one-timer thing. And he's knocked down in front by McLennan, who will hold on for a face-off with 13 minutes to go. L10 is working on that thing that I shouldn't say out loud. Use your imagination. Oh, Shockmaster whiffs on the one-timer. Hollimer tries to pass across to Sasquatch. You can't find that one. Keith Acton is taken down by Shockmaster. Rips the shot all the way through the glass. Smashola. Off a new puck, new painted glass. It's amazing how fast they can change the glass back then. Oh, Armin trying a fancy little deke move. Can't get that one past McClellan. And the puck bounces out of play. Line two coming in for Anaheim. Face off against the number one line of the Islanders. Pass is stolen by Maurer. Maurer with a quick deke move. Can't find it. Steve Thomas is taken down. Bo Jackson picks it up. Bo Jackson gives it to Spencer Robinson. Spencer Robinson tries to cross ice it to Maurer, but it's knocked away. Ray Ferraro coming up for the Islanders. He's hassled and upended. Won't be able to get the shot off. Bo Jackson gives it to Hubert Maurer. Maurer back to Jackson. Jackson tries a cross ice pass, but the chance will intercept it and give it Ferraro's taken down by Nova Fox. Oh, Nova Fox scores! How about that one? Unassisted for his first goal of his career.
Goal scored by number 16.
That was a very fancy, slick move there. Sly like a fox. 11-0 here with 10 minutes left in the final stanchion. Shot won by the Islanders. Yuri Krupp was quickly taken down by Genghis Khan. Genghis Khan rips a shot and is stopped. And by the net, Krupp taken down by Genghis Khan. Oh, the one-timer try, but it can't get the trigger pulled. But it hangs onto it. Face off. Well, the teams will make a quick line change now. Lennon's left. Won by the Islanders in their defensive zone. Steve Thomas is taken down by Jimmy Sasquatch. And Oliver goes offside. Face off back outside. Islander zone, won by the Islanders. Derek King taken down by the Fox. Oh, the quick one-timer. Spencer Robinson can't find the back of the net. Come the Islanders, coming back the other way. Dennis Vasky gives it to Ray Ferraro, whose pass is intercepted by Nathan Hormond, who can't find anywhere to go with that one. Steve Thomas is upended. Fox is held up. Islanders and Ducks making a line change. Bo Jackson coming up. Bo Jackson rips up. Big slapper. Stopped by McLennan. Ducks will be offside, so Pseudonym will hold on to it for a moment. Oh, Jackson turns it right over, and then he steals his own interception. Wide out, Jeff. Oh, and then he scores again. Not another unassisted goal, because Bo Jackson doesn't need anyone's help.
Goal scored by number 43.
Bo Jackson. You're ridiculous. This off won by the Isles. It's Hassel. And taken out by Jimmy Sasquatch. And that's a shot and he scores. Because he can't stop scoring. Unassisted goal for Jimmy Sasquatch.
Anaheim goal scored by number 38.
His first of his career, too. Oh, that's going to be a penalty.
Anaheim penalty to number 24. 2 minutes for tripping at 13:06.
Have a nice trip. See you next fall. Yeah, that was pretty blatant. Off one by the Ducks. Pseudonym rips the shot. Stopped by McLennan. McLennan's pass intercepted by Genghis Khan. Genghis Khan. Shot knocked down in front. Sasquatch's shot is just wide of the net, but it's knocked away by McLennan. Picked up neon boards by Tom Curvers. Curvers will dump it. Well, he'll flying it over the end boards. Instead, we'll bring up a line change for both teams. 6 minutes left here in the final stanchion of play. Unless the Islanders score 11 goals, or 13 goals, and tie it up, but that's not going to happen, is it? Ray Ferraro with a long shot. Stopped. Gives it to Silent Will, gives it to Bo Jackson, whose shot is wide. Take it down. Oh, Cummins can't pick up. Loose puck. As Matt Cummins brings up for the Ducks, they'll make a quick shot. That's picked up by Malikov. Gives it to Krupp, and then the Islanders will be offsides. With 4.5 to play. It's off one by the Ducks. Ormond, quick shot. Bad save by McLennan. Here comes Derek Thomas, or Steve Thomas. Derek Thomas was a football player. Oh, right in front of the net. Come on, get it out. Ah! Hormond, long backhander. Stopped. Huey Krupp gives it. Derek King, who's upended. Ray Ferraro picks up the loose puck. Here comes Hormond. Hormond on a breakaway. Oh, he can't find it. He's exhausted from that long shift. The Ducks will make a line change. Michael Hollimer's shot doesn't find the net. Sasquatch will take him down. Sasquatch picking him up on the line change, and he's going to score for the second touchdown of the game.
Anaheim goal for scored by number 38, assisted by number 8.
Oh dear. 14 to nothing. It's getting a little silly now, aren't we? Except one by the Islanders. Travis Green picks up the puck. Upended. Laid off sides. Picked up by the Ducks. By Bo Jackson. Jackson gives it to Spencer Robinson. Oh, the one-timer right in front. Maurer can't find an opening. Here come the Islanders again. Oh dear. That was almost a scary thing. Almost a minute left in that thing that L10 shall not say out loud. It's a one by the Ducks. Ormond.
Last
McKay, he's taken down. Kudinov dumps it. Button picks it up. Hold on to it for a stoppage in play. Quickly regroup. Face off to the left of McLennan. Is won by the Islanders. Loose puck is picked up by Genghis Khan. Oh, Ormond crashes right into McLennan. Bring out the third line for Anaheim for the last 30 seconds. It's off one by the Islanders. Long pass. Take it down. Oh! Steve Thomas can't find it. Oh, whistle that one out, and that's going to be the end of the game. The Ducks win 14 to nothing.
EA Sports third star from Anaheim, number 20. EA Sports second star from Anaheim, number 43.
There's only one man that can top that performance. It's me!
EA Sports first star from Anaheim, number 10.
What a shutout performance! Excellent work, guys!
Here's the scoring summary for the game.
Take a look at the summary for the rest of the game. Now notice it does list their goals scored by the season number. Their cumulative season total, not their goals of the game, so I'll just have to pay attention to that. .75 big shots for the Mighty Ducks, the purple and teal attack. Sasquatch lighting them up twice, the end of the third period.
And elsewhere in the NHL tonight.
By a look at our game statistics. 21 timers. Only 5 penalties this time. Still 106 checks, doubling them up. More than doubling them up. 27 minutes of attack zone. Yeah, you're not going to win the game with only 13 minutes of attack time, Islanders. Sorry. take one last look at our penalties here, and that's going to just about wrap things up for this installment of exciting hockey. Exciting, ridiculous hockey. Yes, I'm afraid this is how the season is going to play out. Scoring absolute ludicrous numbers of goals like it's the 80s on steroids. But why not? It's my hockey game. I'll play it how I want to. It's the only game I'm playing that I'm sure will not kick my butt. All right, let's take a look at our schedule. Next upcoming game will be against the Oilers on the 13th at home. Until that time, keep your head up and your stick on the ice. Thank you for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please like, comment, or subscribe. You can also interact with me on Twitter and Facebook at L1011Widebody. And if you'd like, you can pledge to sponsor me at patreon.com/L1011Widebody.